Hi, my name is Jörg and I'm one of the product managers for PRTG. And in this video, I want to give you an insight on the future developments of PRTG and our roadmap. Have you already activated the experimental features within PRTG? In the last update video, I told you about the implementation of experimental sensors with PRTG version 65. Since you guys showed a lot of interest and had questions for us, we decided to produce a video tutorial. You can find the link to the tutorial with our product owner Johannes below this video. Experimental features are already tested and ready to try, but development work starts way before that. That's why we offer you the opportunity to join a testing and feedback group and see features at an early stage of development. When you participate, you will be invited to see new and experimental solutions for PRTG in an early stage and be able to test them while being assisted by one of our developers. To apply, follow the link in the description. Keeping an eye on the backup of your data is one of the most crucial tasks for sysadmins today. We enhanced our sensors offering for the VM backup solution in the last versions. With the release of VM Backup Job Status and Backup Job Status Advanced sensors, you can now keep track of your backup jobs over the last 24 hours and get detailed information on them. If you want to learn more about VM monitoring, I highly recommend the blog article from my colleague Jasmine. In addition to our Microsoft Azure sensors, we increased the possibilities for PRTG to work together more seamlessly with Azure AD. From version 68 on, you are now able to connect your PRTG installation with Azure AD to get single sign-on authentication for users in your Active Directory. If you want to know how to configure PRTG accordingly, we have linked a video tutorial from our colleague Susanna below. As you may know, our REST custom sensor V1 has been out there for some time, and we are really pleased with how it is evolving and the feedback we've received from you. Nevertheless, the setup isn't a snap. That's why we have created a specialized version that we call REST Custom V2 with enhanced and rapid configuration. To take a deeper dive into what is possible and how to achieve it, we recommend a tutorial video from our colleague Susanna to get started with custom sensors. We at Paessler got a lot of feedback from you regarding the AWS CloudWatch sensors. We have reviewed the old code and decided that it needs a full rewrite. The aim is to give a new and improved solution for each of the previous sensors and to even add new ones. To get a better overview of the changes, we recommend the blog article from our colleague Sasha. While continuing to develop new features for data center environments, we are excited to release our first experimental Redfish sensor. The Redfish standard is the successor of the well-known IPMI standard and supported by many big hardware manufacturers such as Dell, HPE, and Lenovo, among others. Therefore, we are pretty sure that your network will benefit from this monitoring approach. Redfish sensors are an elegant way to monitor a lot of equipment from different manufacturers without complex customization steps for the users. To give you a better insight about the idea of Redfish and how it can help you, we will come up with explanatory content in the next month. That's it for today. If you have any questions about PRTG development, leave them in the comment section below. I will answer as well as I can. Thanks for watching and see you next time.